I went there on a middle school field trip. I got engaged there. We've celebrated every wedding anniversary there. It looked like a war zone, like someone had dropped a bomb. We never thought the river would be coming down the street.
After this devastating 2016 flash flood, residents in Ellicott City worked hard to recover and reopen their businesses. Less than 2 years later, another flash flood tore down Main Street.
I just kept thinking, I can't believe we're going down this road again. We are going to have to make some changes if we think we're going to protect people in the future. There is an element of acceptance that we will flood again.
These events remind us how important it is for communities to understand their flood risk and use that information to help reduce risk. In San Marcos, Texas, a close call in 2015 prompted the Rand family to learn more about their flood risk.
The water had come to our floorboards. We did not get flood damage, but it was down to the wire. The house is full of so many memories, and I cannot imagine what it would feel like to lose all of this. In terms of how the house is raised right now, we are currently about 8.5 feet up in the air. The reason we were really emphatic that we wanted to go this height is we met with the city engineer who showed us the flood elevation maps.
Floodplains are typically low-lying areas that carry and disperse water. Flood risk is dynamic, and everyone has some form of risk. Flood risk is informed by flood hazards in your area, such as storms, changing weather patterns, development, and sometimes changes to the landscape. These and other hazards can be dangerous for people and property, so to determine flood risk, officials must consider the following. How likely is it to happen? How often does it happen? And how bad could it be? But as a community changes, so can its flood risk. Some of that change is caused by people and some by nature.
The interesting thing about Ellicott City is its topography. It is a steep slope with narrow river channels. When it rains really hard, the water moves real fast, and if it gets real deep, it comes out of the channels, and then it just goes down Main Street.
Communities do have the ability to lower their flood risk. Preventative measures, also known as mitigation, can improve a community's chances of avoiding catastrophic damage. Smart land use and building codes, green infrastructure, floodproofing, or raising a home's elevation are just a few solutions that can change the future of a community.
Some of the simplest things are just to be aware of what's going on around you, to have a plan. Different home improvement projects that people might undertake, it may sound simple, but just, you know, your gutters, making sure that all of those are free of debris that can actually keep the water off your home. We've done several things in San Marcos to mitigate risk. We actually changed our floodplain ordinance, and so we require folks to build 2 feet above the flood level in the permitting process. I think we feel more prepared in the way that we understand what can happen and how quickly water can rise. We hope that people, through the things that we've experienced, have a special awareness to that.
At first, your flood risk might seem intimidating, but taking action to reduce flood risk can save you money on flood insurance and also save so much more. Learn more about your flood risk and how to better prepare your community against flooding. Visit FEMA.gov/mitigation.